Hi there, RC Maniacs. Let me start by saying that the title of this video should probably have been Single Rotor Helicopters Are Dinosaurs. And let me also say that being an old guy, I've spent a number of years and a lot of effort learning how to fly single rotor helicopters, so I'm a huge fan of them. But I can see the writing on the wall, and it's pretty clear. You know, there's been a quiet revolution, or maybe not so quiet revolution, going on in helicopter technology over the last few years.
Of course, I'm talking about multi-rotor helicopters. Now, here in front of me, I have just a small sampling of multi-rotor helicopters. You know, everything from the tiny little Air Hogs X4 Helix, or Helix X4 Stunt, on up to a little more involved models, up to the DJI Phantom, which is the quadcopter that I use most often. But this is just a tiny sampling of the hundreds of multicopters that are available. You know, tricopters, quadcopters, hexacopters with 6 blades, octocopters with 8 blades. I've even seen them on up to 10, 12, 14 blade helicopters. There's just an amazing variety and availability of all kinds of different multi-rotors nowadays.
You see them on TV, on YouTube, in people's backyards, at flying clubs, everywhere. If you haven't seen one recently flying somewhere, you're probably living under a rock. They are taking the world by storm. And here's the 5 reasons why I believe that they will completely replace single rotor helicopters eventually, and maybe not that far off. Number 1, complexity. Number 2, ease of control. Number 3, safety. Number 4, popularity. And number 5, stability. Now we're going to go into each one of these in a little more detail so that you can understand why I think that they're going to take over. Alright, first off, complexity. Single rotor helicopters are extremely complex, especially collective pitch helis such as 3D helicopters. Okay? They literally have hundreds of fragile mechanical moving parts that all have to work perfectly with each other in order to fly smoothly or to even fly at all. A single tiny broken mechanical part can easily cause a crash. Flybar helicopters, which are the oldest technology, have many mechanical parts just in the head alone, all of which will probably be damaged or broken in the event of a crash. Flybarless heads have less moving parts, but they're still quite complex, and they're also very fragile and may be damaged if the helicopter wrecks. In addition, tail rotors are required because a single spinning rotor is unstable. You have to have some way to counteract the torque and the yaw that the single spinning rotor causes. Tail rotors typically use either a belt or a torque tube design, linking the tail rotor to the main rotor by gears or belts, and this has to be maintained on a regular basis. Tail rotors also need to spin approximately 4 times as fast as the main rotor, and of course it needs even more gearing to spin the tail rotor faster. This adds to the mechanical complexity and also for the more chances for mechanical failures. In contrast, most multi-rotor helicopters are much simpler in design. A typical quadcopter like this is 4 motors with relatively small propellers mounted directly on the motor shaft. No complex head design, no belts or shafts, in fact, very few mechanical moving parts at all. This is because of technology. All of the balancing and damping that happens in the single rotor head is all handled by a solid state circuit board, not mechanical moving parts. In the event of a crash, usually one or more of the props break, maybe even a motor fails, and can be easily replaced, maybe even at the field if you have the spare parts. With a single rotor heli crash, it may require weeks on the workbench to repair all of the mechanical moving parts and get them all working correctly together again. So most multi-rotor helicopters have many less moving parts that can fail as opposed to single rotor helis. Ease of control. This is a very important point. Single rotor helicopters, especially collective pitch 3D helicopters like this, are inherently unstable. And they are the most difficult thing to master in RC. In fact, they're so difficult to control that many pilots will not even fly at the same field with a new helipilot if he has less than 2 years or so of practice. The reason is that most new single rotor helipilots have a lot of crashes and do not start to feel comfortable about their flying abilities for months or even years. Even full-scale helicopter pilots often admit that helicopters are very unstable and hard to control. On the other hand, multi-rotor helicopters, by their very design, are more inherently stable. In a typical quad configuration like this one, two of the props spin in one direction, and two of the props spin in the opposite direction. This means that the prop torque and the heading yaw mostly cancels each other out automatically. In addition, almost all multi-rotor helis have multiple axis gyros built in to auto-balance a heli. Many also have GPS stabilization and altitude control. With these built-in features, the multi-rotor becomes so easy to fly that almost anyone can pick up the controller and fly it with a few minutes of practice. In fact, it makes them almost too easy to fly sometimes, which leads us to the very next discussion, which is safety. There are two very different points of view on safety. The first view is that multi-rotor helis are much safer because of the built-in stabilization electronics. Multi-axis gyros, GPS, altimeter control, safe technology auto-balancing, etc., all of this. And that's very true. Also because normally the blades are much smaller on a multi-rotor heli, there's much less chance of injury during a crash if the blades come off. Large single-rotor helicopters have huge heavy blades, swinging at up to 3,500 revolutions per minute. These turn into flying knives splintering in all directions on a crash. Another point for multi-rotor helicopters is that many of them can be programmed to survive a single or even a multiple rotor failure and land safely. A single rotor helicopter just can't do this. If it loses the rotor, it's going down. Now the second point of view, our argument about safety, is also just as valid. And here it is. Multi-rotor helicopters are so easy to fly that literally anyone can pick up the controller and start flying it. This means that many of the Maltese flying are being controlled by very inexperienced pilots. And I use that term very loosely because these are people with no flying experience whatsoever. They have no idea how to handle orientation of a flying aircraft. They will not understand how to fly. They rarely belong to a flying organization such as AMA that promotes safe flying. And so they have no concept of flying safety or how to avoid dangerous situations with a flying aircraft. This can be very dangerous to everyone in the area. And this is a very real concern, and I agree with it. But it's not a problem with the multi-rotor helicopter itself. It's a people problem. And it can be reduced or eliminated with education and experience. So in my opinion, the multi-rotor helicopters themselves are generally safer to fly than the single-rotor helicopters. Or another way to say it is that a pilot with the same level of experience will most likely be a little safer with a multi-rotor than a single-rotor. That brings us down to popularity. This is a big one. Why did we like single rotor helicopters when they first came out? Isn't it because they could do something that no other aircraft could do? They don't need a runway. They can hover over the same spot for as long as you want. They can fly backwards, sideways, in all directions really, even upside down. Well, multi-rotor helicopters can do all those same things. But instead of being difficult to fly, they are typically very easy to control, even for beginners. This makes them extremely popular because anybody could use it. In fact, multi-rotor helicopters is by far the biggest and fastest growing segment of RC. And it's growing faster than any other RC segment has ever grown in the past in terms of number of multi-rotors being purchased. This is due to several factors. For one, they're cool looking. They're futuristic. They kind of look like UFOs. Also, they are very easy to control, as I just mentioned. You don't need months or years of practice to learn how to fly one. And another huge factor is cost. You can buy a quad for under $100 now, okay, that flies as good and as stable as one that costs $5,000 or more. And lastly, and maybe most importantly, they make great platforms for aerial video filming. And that leads me right in to the last point, which is stabilization. Stability. For video photography, multi-rotors can't be beat. They are excellent video platforms. They can hover in place for minutes or hours, depending on your power supply. With GPS and altitude control, they can even hover by themselves or follow waypoints and video things along the way. There's all kinds of motorized gimbals and controls that will help you better utilize the camera, keep it stable, aim it the right direction. I often use a quadcopter to film things from the air for my RC videos. I have even used it to fly other aircraft past it while it's flying autonomously by itself. As the technology gets better and better, I believe this will by far become the platform of choice for all aerial photography. So there you have it. The five reasons why I believe that multi-rotors are taking over. It's my opinion that single-rotor helicopters are dinosaurs. And like the dinosaurs, they are doomed to a slow extinction. You will see less and less of them and more of multi-rotor helicopters as the technology gets better and better. Of course, this won't happen overnight. The majority always resists change instead of embracing it, so this will happen over time as everyone gets comfortable and used to multi-rotor helicopters. I myself still love single-rotor helicopters. In fact, I'm working on building a brand new SAB Goblin 700 size single rotor helicopter right now. And here it is. So I have nothing against single rotor helicopters. I love them. They're great. But considering everything that we've discussed here, it may be very likely that this is the last single rotor helicopter that I will ever build. So join the revolution and check out multi-rotor helicopters today. And remember, change in technology can be good. Long live the revolution, baby.